I'm going to present a work related to the use of portfolio methodology. This is the outline of the presentation. First, I'm going to introduce some aspect of the portfolio methodology. Then I present the objectives of the work. The following section they go to explain our experience in the implementation of a portfolio methodology in the context of a computer degree in the University of Salamanca. We present the results of this implementation, and finally I present the conclusions. The term portfolio, as we know, is used in many application domains, for example, in the context of company project, in civil context, and so on. But our work is focused in the educational context. In this context, portfolio is used for evaluating and monitoring the learning process. So in this context, the portfolio is the selection of evidence samples that the student can collect in order to improve their skill and to pass the subject where the portfolio methodology is applied. So these evidences allow on the one hand to the student to improve their learning, and to the teacher to track the learning progress of the students that are participating in the portfolio methodology. And that evidences must be accompanied by a justification and some reflection about some aspect of the learning process. It's a characteristic of the portfolio is that the work is individual, is personal for every student, but there is a mechanism based on the teacher feedback that allows the student to improve, to acquire some skills, and in this way to pass the subject that is the final objective of the student. The objective of our work is mainly to analyze the methodology, the portfolio methodology, and to examine if that methodology plays a good or a bad role in the learning process. This work is part of a teaching innovation project in the University of Salamanca. And the aim of this project is to help the students to improve their skills. Some of them are specific of the subject, but some of them are transversal competencies, like, for example, the capacity of writing, planning, self-learning, and so on. With this project, we expected to improve some aspects of the teaching. For example, the guidance of the students, improve the result, to help in the process of learning by means of the interactive system, to improve the communication with the teacher, and some other important skills in the learning. The step for complete the portfolio are given in this graph. In the first step, the students must collect the evidences. They must put together in a document. In the second step, the student must select the best result and send to the teacher. In the following step, the student must write a reflection of the weaknesses and strengths of the methodology. And finally, in the publication step, they have to organize the evidences and they have to publish the evidence. We implemented this methodology for a subject, the database subject, in a computer degree in the University of Salamanca, I've commented before. We have a problem because this university has no platform specific to this kind of methodology. So we use the general platform, but we created two different sites. The first one was for the entire group of the student, of the subject, and the second one was for the student participating in the portfolio project. The first day of class, the teacher explained the characteristics of the portfolio, the way of working, and they told to the user that is the methodology, the learning methodology used in the subject. However, this methodology is not part of the program of the science, so the teacher or the professor explained to the student that the participation in this kind of experience doesn't change the grade of the exam. However, the teacher tried to involve the students in the portfolio work, because we think that it can be useful. It can provide the advice to the students. The parts of the portfolio we implemented was cover, reflection, and monitoring and test. In the cover part, the students must to do a presentation of themselves and explain their knowledge in the subject, the portfolio. The reflection and analysis of learning can have the purpose of obtaining the evaluation of the methodology from the student. So he must do reflection about the difficulty of the exercise, the time spent in solving them, and so on. Monitoring dates are related with the deadline, deadline for every task. We established some rules for the portfolio, mainly that the work is individual, and if a student has some delay in the delivery of some tasks, they is expulsed of the team. We developed several activities. The first exercise is mainly oriented to the skills of the introductory lessons, the theoretical lessons. So the student must propose for question or for the exam, they are multiple choice questions, and the teacher just put together the questions in a document and to give the document. referring to the practical exercises, we propose two, that the two exercises related to the subject, for example, that it will grab the design of a database. The students must explain step by step the resolution of this exercise. This kind of exercise has to review for the teacher. In the first review, the teacher just provide to the student general consideration about the mistake, but in the second review, if the mistake persists, the teacher provide a specific explanation about the specific mistakes. All the information is collected in the same file, PDF, or both the student and the teacher have together all the information about the exercise, the solution, the review of these exercises. And finally, in the experiment, participate 10 students out of the 4 that compound the group of the subject. One has a delay in the delivery of the task, so finally the study was made in 9 students. The results were quite good because 75% of the participants in the experience passed the subject in the first call, and in the second call, the 10% of the students passed the subject. We also asked the students about the degree of conformity about some aspects that in the slide. I can say that the grade of satisfaction in all the aspects were very high. And finally, as conclusion, we can say that we have analyzed the use of the improv polys in the context of a computing degree. The result was very good. And we can say that there is a drawback, that is that the time spent by the teacher. So we can conclude, it's our opinion, that this kind of methodology can be applied when we have groups of students not very large. That's all. Thank you.